What do you think about Korea? I mean, that state is so iniquitous. You're talking about persecution of Christians. There isn't anything as terrible as Kim Jong-un and his crowd. But should we have done something different? Should we have followed MacArthur?
It's a bit of a parlor game to answer that question these days. I've studied that history when I was a cadet at West Point. It was remarkable what MacArthur did, a graduate of the same college I'm from. I don't know what the right answer was that day. I do know what the right answer is today.
Oh, yeah.
And we tried desperately to get Chairman Kim to give up his nuclear weapons. I was privileged to be the first man in when I was a CIA director. I went on a clandestine mission to meet with Chairman Kim to make the case for him giving them up. I mean, what he does to his own people, right? 25 million plus people all live in destitute poverty with no religious freedom. And it is absolutely tragic, one of the worst humanitarian crises of this century. We weren't completely successful. We got him to stop doing a lot of the testing that was taking place that threatens the United States, but he still has his nuclear weapons. We need to keep praying, and this administration needs to keep working. And if we can get that right, we can denuclearize the Korean Peninsula, and really good things for those 25 million people can follow.
You think he'll ever do it?
It's going to take pressure from the United States and pressure from China, both of us.
China's not going to
cool off. To date, we didn't see the pressure from China. They have an interest in it as well. Nuclear weapons in North Korea aren't a good thing for them, but but they view it as a buffer. They view it as a space between them and the South Koreans.
Kim is testing now. He's launching some more rockets.
Those short-range ballistic missiles. Yeah. He hasn't done any of the long-range missiles, nor has he conducted nuclear tests.
Mm-hmm.
Those are things that matter an awful lot to our security here in the homeland. But in the end, Chairman Kim with a nuclear weapon is a very unstabilizing, very dangerous thing for not only the United States, but for the entire world.
Well, are the Iranians getting nuclear technology from North Korea? Is that where they're getting it?
So there's a history of the two of them. What's the right way to describe it? Playing footsie?
Okay.
So there is a relationship between the two countries. There's a lot of work that goes into making sure that the risk of proliferation of these nuclear weapons from North Korea to Iran doesn't take place. And Iran, as a result of that, has chosen to try and build it out itself, try to make a homegrown system. But we do always worry that North Korea will transport a nuclear weapon somewhere. Could be to Iran, could be someplace else as well. When you have someone like Chairman Kim in possession of a nuclear weapon, it is a very, very dangerous
thing. You know, I noticed that Biden did something that I sort of applauded. He finally called the slaughter of the Armenian Christians genocide, and we've been unwilling to do that to this time. Turkey and with Erdogan is sort of a difficult problem. And how do you see, did he play that one right or not?
So I actually agree. I always support good decisions. In this case, President Biden made a good decision. I'm happy to second his motion there. I'm glad that he did that. It was a long time coming, and he picked a historic moment to do it. So good for their administration for having done that. Turkey's complicated. We were very challenged there. It began with trying to free Pastor Brunson.
Yes.
So my first mission in Turkey was that. We were fortunate. The Lord smiled upon us, and we got Pastor Brunson back home. But we were still challenged by President Erdogan, who has an understanding of the world where he denies religious freedom to his own people, where he has this an idea about greater Turkish empire building. It's most unfortunate. Turkey is a member of NATO, and they have not acted consistent with their obligations to NATO. And so we pushed back on them pretty hard. We sanctioned them. We pulled an important weapon system out. They were building parts of our joint strike fighter. We pulled that program back from them. I hope Turkey will come to see that their best path forward is to join with the West and not join with an Islamist understanding of the world. That won't serve the Turkish people well.
Well, you know, it's amazing that Santa Sophia Church, he decided to make a mosque.
It's so sad.
Yeah, it's terrible.
So sad. Not long after they did that, I traveled to Turkey and met to support another faith leader, the Ecumenical Patriarch there. I had the chance to meet him in Istanbul, former Constantinople in Istanbul. It was glorious to be at the seat of the Greek Orthodox Church and to see those Christian believers in a very challenging place there in Turkey.
What do you think? You know, I used to think that China would be the largest Christian nation on the face of the earth. We saw so many people coming to the Lord in China. It was overwhelming. And there seems to be a religious revival. Are you heartened by the fact that there's so many people coming to the Lord? I mean, there really is a spiritual revival in the world, yeah, despite these
things. I see it in so many places. I saw it in Africa.
Yeah.
I saw it in places in South America. I'm confident that that spirit is alive and well inside of China as well, in spite of the authoritarian regime that tries to push it away and denies the house churches even the capacity to practice their faith. I am confident that the Chinese people, too, will come to see the Lord in big numbers.
Yeah.
It would be a glorious thing. I think all across the world, God is touching hearts and changing lives. Mm. I'm incredibly optimistic as a result of that.
Well, I'm thrilled. Oh, what's your future? Have you got any plans for your own destiny? You've got a long way to go.
First of all, the plans are the Lord's.
Yeah, okay.
But what I know so far about those plans is I'm going to take this time to do some writing, mm-hmm, and I'm going to take this time to help candidates be successful so that Republicans can be successful in 2022. Beyond that, you know, there's a big election in 2024. We are thinking our way through that, but for the moment, we are just focused like a laser on making sure that 2022 proves to be a time where there's a turning in Washington, D.C.
Well, there will be. Well, you have such a distinguished career, and we're so grateful for you being here. And all I can say is we wish you God's blessing, and I'll ask this audience, make sure you pray for Secretary Mike Pompeo. He is a great man of God and a distinguished. Read all of your accomplishments as I introduce you to speak to Regent. It's just incredible what you have accomplished.
Well, that's very kind.
We're so honored to have you with us. God bless you.
God bless you, too. Thank you.